Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas.
Welcome back to This Week at River Edge for our Christmas edition.
This week I am filling in for Kelsey, and we have a lot to discuss, including the psychology class Deviance Day, Toys for Tots, and Spirit Week.
I'm sure the whole school noticed the kids of the Highland psychology class walking around Monday completely out of character. They were offered 25 extra credit points to participate in Deviance Day. The students were asked to dress up in attire out of their personal norm with hopes of understanding what it would be like to walk in someone else's shoes. Here's Kelly with several Deviance Day participants.
Thanks, guys. I'm here with Lauren, and she is part of the psychology class at Highland. Can you explain the project that you're doing right now?
Well, it's called Deviance Day, and our teacher wanted us to all dress up as something we're not. Like, I'm a gangster, and I'm not usually a gangster. And so she wanted us to dress up and get the reactions of everybody so we can see how people react to, like, new situations.
And what have you learned from this project, and what are some of the reactions that you've gotten so far?
Well, I've learned that people don't like change. Like, one of my reactions was, "What are you wearing?" And, "You need to pull your pants up, because no, you can't do that." And it's just different in how people, like, react to me and how I look different.
That's cool. Thanks, Lauren.
You're welcome, Kelly.
I'm here with Alyssa. And how did you like the experience of Deviance Day?
It was pretty interesting. It was a whole new experience to see what it's like to kind of walk in someone else's shoes for the day.
And what are some of the results that you got from Deviance Day?
I definitely got a lot of stares. I know Mr. Vandego had an issue with it because me and Morgan, like, switched bodies for the day, so it was kind of weird.
Thanks. Now back to Carrie in the studio.
Toys for Tots is an annual tradition put on by the Riverridge FFA. Every year they create incentives for different age groups to raise money for the Toys for Tots program. There will be an assembly today to find out who raised the most money, how much the school collected as a whole, and to present a check to Brenda Toot of the total earnings. Remember, today is bills and checks. Be sure to donate to this good cause. Now to Kelly with Mr. Curry, as well as Morgan, to discuss the program.
Thanks, girls. I'm here with Mr. Curry. So why does the FFA organize the Toys for Tots?
About 8 years ago, Mr. Akers, who was our principal at the time, came up to us and was a big proponent of the Toys for Tots organization and asked if the FFA would be interested in organizing a fund drive for Toys for Tots.
Okay, and what is the goal for this year?
Our goal this year is $2,000. We've been raising about that much, and we thought that's an achievable goal and a nice amount to give to needy children.
Thank you.
Everyone, get excited for Spirit Week. It starts on Monday, January 27th. The dress-up days to be preparing for are in order: Multiple Day, Reality TV Show Day, Summer Day, Senior Citizen Day, and Spirit Day. Friday morning, the high school will be taking a bowling trip, and upon arriving back at the school in the afternoon, the high school boys are going to entertain us with Iron Man Volleyball. Friday night, the junior class will be putting on a soup and sandwich fundraiser at the boys' basketball game. So be sure to prepare and find a junior next month for your tickets. County, on Saturday night from 7 to 9 p.m., there will be an open gym in place of the traditional dance. $3 per person or $5 per couple, or bring 3 cans of food. All proceeds will be donated to the local food pantries. Now here's to Kelly with Mrs. Einsweiler.
Thanks, girls. I'm here with Mrs. Ines. And what is the week of Spirit Week?
The last week of January.
And what are the dress-up days?
Monday is multiple days, so you get a group of people together and dress up the same. Tuesday is reality TV. Mr. Folks said no snooki. And Wednesday is summer. Mr. Folks said no bikinis. And Thursday is Senior Citizen Day, and Friday is Spirit Day.
And can you kind of explain Iron Man volleyball to me?
We started it last year. It's the opposite of Powder Puff. So the boys are playing volleyball, and the freshmen, sophomore, junior, seniors, and then they all play, and then the winners play the winners, and the losers play the losers, and you get the overall champs.
That sounds really fun. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Now back to the newsroom.
I hope everyone has written their letters to Santa. Here's Kelly with the elementary students on what they want for Christmas.
So, Berkeley and Peyton, what do you want from Santa this year?
I want a toy train, colorful one.
I want a doll.
Great, thanks guys. Kayla and Jeremiah, what do you want from Santa this year?
10 packs of jerky.
The Empire Strikes Back movie.
Awesome. Okay, Seth, Macy, what do you want for Christmas this year?
I want an iPod.
A Kindle.
Cool. Heaven and LeBron, what do you want for Christmas this year?
A keyboard?
Video games?
Cool. Kari, Brayton, can you name all the reindeer?
Yeah. Dasher.
Dancer.
Prancer.
Vixen.
Comet.
Cupid.
Donner.
Blitzen.
Rudolph.
Rudolph. Okay, Anna, Jacob, what's your favorite part about Christmas?
Mine would have to be turkey and presents, because the gravy's the best on turkey.
My favorite part would be getting to see your family.
That's great, guys. Mr. Dimmer, what do you want for Christmas this year?
I would like to see peace in the Middle East.
Well, we're learning about that in government right now, so I think that might be kind of hard. Do you have another wish?
I would like to see the Bears win the Super Bowl.
What was your first one again?
Now, here's a word from our sponsors.
What's better, bigger or smaller?
Bigger!
What's the biggest number of senior candy bars you can eat?
A million, trillion, billion!
That's pretty big. How about you?
10.
Okay, how about you?
Infinity!
That's a lot.
Infinity in one!
Actually, the answer we're looking for is infinity plus infinity.
What about infinity times infinity?
Now here's to sports.
Thanks, guys. This week was a slow week for both girls and boys basketball. The girls basketball team headed over to Scales Mound to play Potosi on Monday night. The girls played a very good game, with Katie Snitzler coming out as the high scorer with 26 points that night. Tonight, the girls will head over to Savannah to play the West Carroll Lady Thunder. And tomorrow, the girls will be heading over to Pearl City to play Fulton at 5 o'clock, and the Fresh Soft team will be playing in Galena for their tournament. We wish the girls the best of luck tonight and tomorrow, and we hope to see positive results from all the games.
The boys started this week out with a game against Fulton Unity and claimed a victory with a score of 58-46. Then the team played Lee Lynn on Thursday night, and we will have the result from that game next week. If you aren't doing anything on Saturday, make sure you go out to Forreston to watch the boys as they compete in the Forreston tournament.
Because this is our last video before Christmas break, here's what to expect in the weeks to come. On Tuesday, the varsity girls will be heading to Pearl City to play Orangeville to finish out the Pearl City tournament. The girls will also be playing on Thursday and Friday with those times and opponents to be decided. The JV girls will also be playing in the Galena tournament on Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday.
The boys will be having a varsity Forreston tournament in Forreston Tuesday, Wednesday, and Friday with times and opponents to be decided. The JV tournament will be at Galena on Thursday.
Thanks, now back to you guys.
Thanks, guys. Now to weather.
Thanks, guys. Today's going to be partly cloudy with a high of 68 and a low of 40. Lauren, what did you do now?
Sorry, that's Arizona. This is the real one.
Thanks. Okay, it's actually going to be partly cloudy with a high of 29 and a low of 19 with a 10% chance of precipitation. Yeah, that sounds about right, unfortunately. Saturday is going to have about a 30% chance of snow showers with a high 29 and a low of 14. Sunday is going to be about 22 degrees with a 10% chance of snow. And Monday is going to be cloudy with a high of 33 and a low of 19 with 20% chance of precipitation. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Erin. Here's the current events.
Hi, we're current events. I'm Micah.
Gavin.
And I'm Jacob.
Just recently, the House and Senate Budget Committee agreed on a spending bill that would increase domestic and military spending. This agreement would also hit on programs that would make airline tickets, ticket prices increase, and they would increase to pay for airport security.
Nelson Mandela, the president of South Africa, just died recently. His funeral was attended by over 90 world leaders, in South Africa.
As recently in Nevada, a family on a trip in their Jeep ended up flipping over off the road and had to survive 2 days by only using warm rocks to keep warm.
Thanks, boys. Now here's to Lauren with announcements.
Thanks, guys. And now for this week's announcements. Seniors, your baby project is due to Miss Lord on Monday. The slideshow picks for the senior slideshow are due next Friday. And if your name is outside Miss Smith's door, seniors, make sure you go and see her. The elementary Christmas concert is next Wednesday. And for Mr. Dent's class, all the quarter projects are going to start next week. And Mr. Dentmer says, juniors, get your Illinois History Fair done. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Lauren. Now to Mr. Van Gogh's joke of the week.
Hey, James.
What?
What do you call a snowman in the summer? A puddle.
Oh.
It's too bad Kelsey wasn't here to hear that joke.
No, it's too bad that I am here to hear that joke. We will not be having an episode next week due to the busyness in preparing for break. So in that case, we hope you all have a very Merry Christmas.
And as always, we'll try to do better next time.
Merry Christmas!
Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad, próspero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad, feliz Navidad.